Okay, I think I'm in the right place. Oh, bike helmets. You're John, right?
Yep, I'm John Galtafiore. I oversee the bike helmet testing here.
I've been dying to see you all week. All right, how do I look?
Well, I think that helmet needs some work, but I can fix it. Let's go.
Oh gosh, all right, let's go.
Since their introduction in the mid-1800s, these two-wheeled locomotion machines have become a hit with people around the world. But the first real bicycle helmets didn't show up until the 1970s. Today, modern helmets come in lots of different shapes, designs, and colors. But how do they work to protect your noggin? The Consumer Reports Bicycle Helmet Test Lab has the answer.
John, so I see a helmet in your hand, and I'm asking myself, you know, what's the big deal about this? I see so many people riding a bicycle without a helmet. Is it really that important?
Yeah, it's really important to have a helmet, because if you crash on your bike, you have an accident, you fall, you want to put something between your skull and that pavement.
To get an idea of how well helmets protect your head, John has created a simple yet effective demonstration with a cantaloupe.
Wait, so this is gonna simulate a head just crashing down?
Yeah, that's what we try to do. It's just a demonstration, but it shows you what happens when you're unprotected.
Ouch! That looked like it hurt.
So Jack, you can see, it took some pretty serious damage.
So this is supposed to be a head falling to the ground?
Well, it's a good demonstration for teenagers.
Next, John puts the cantaloupe in a helmet, and oh, what a difference that helmet makes.
Hey, not much happened to it.
In this case, the helmet absorbed the energy and protected what would be somebody's head.
So helmets do work.
Helmets work.
John, I'm pretty pumped about this place. Okay, so testing time. How tall is this machine?
This thing is about 20 feet into the air. Basically, there's an accelerometer in here. So once that helmet hits this platform, this accelerometer, which is hooked up to a computer, will tell us how many G's that helmet was able to absorb.
G's, or the G-forces, measure an object's acceleration. 1G is equal to the force of the Earth's gravitational pull. The more G's a helmet can withstand, the more it protects your speeding head.
John, enough talking. Can I see this baby in action?
Absolutely.
Once the helmet is strapped into place, the computer does the rest.
And there it goes. And this is gonna go all the way up.
So you might want to stand just a little back,
okay,
because you're coming down at 13.9 miles an hour.
Oof. Okay, there's a dent right in there.
Sometimes if you look on the other side of the helmet, you can actually see some cracking.
Oh, look at that. A little bit of cracking right there.
It's really important to know that's a good thing. When you see cracking, you know that the helmet absorbed the energy and that's not your skull that's gonna be cracked.
John, this is very good work that you do. How does that feel for you?
It's really important because I have three kids of my own, and when they go out riding their bikes, I want them to have a safe helmet, and I also want everybody to have a safe helmet.
John, I have a teenager that wants to ask a question about bike helmets. Let's ask CR.
Hey Jack, I'm Dara. I'm a teenager who loves riding my bike, and I just got this new helmet, and I was wondering, how do I know if it fits right?
Excellent question. Turns out there are four main things to watch out for. First, check the fit.
So here we're gonna go and just put this on.
So first you wanna make sure that it feels comfortable on your head without the straps.
Okay.
No pressure points, make sure it fits the shape of your head, which this looks pretty good, it does that job.
Next, check the straps.
You wanna make sure those straps are right below your ear. So now that we got the side straps adjusted, and see if it feels a little better.
Here we go. Hey, that feels much more snug.
Then, check the tilt.
So what you wanna do is you wanna pull up on it, and you can see that, you know, that's still a little loose, exposing your forehead. So what we do is we have to tighten up that strap just a little bit more.
Finally, there's something called the mouth test.
Just kinda open your mouth wide.
All right.
Do you feel that helmet pulling down a little bit?
Yes, I do.
That shows that it's properly fit.
There we go.
And bonus points for making a funny face.
All right, John. I think I'm ready to go. How does it look?
Looks great. You're ready to ride.
All right. I'll see you later.
Okay, take care, Jack.
All right, bye.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. Thank you.